I'd like to take this opportunity to express my sincere appreciation to all the ladies and gentlemen for coming to this media session for Myanmar. So as introduced by MC, my name is Mr. Dean, and I'm Deputy Director for International and Regional Cooperation Department for the Ministry of Hotels and Tourism of Myanmar. And nice to meet you all, and we'll just introduce where is Myanmar, very simple, and also secondly, the laws and policy, as well as the third point, I would like to focus the strategies and visions of our tourism industry in Myanmar, and the fourth one is about the some tourism statistics. Maybe you might have interest to know what is the trends and situations of tourism industry in Myanmar. And the fifth one is about the visa and also the connectivity of our country. And 6, 7, 8 is about the tourism, what kinds of tourism resources we have in Myanmar, and why investors should invest in Myanmar. And the key point number 8 just mentioned what we did in 2023. So this is just the introductions of my presentation. The first one is, I'm not sure all of you are aware about Myanmar, so just, you know, I put in these slides to introduce you all that where is Myanmar. So as you can see on the screen that Myanmar is located, you know, between the very big countries, China and India, and also we have border with Thailand, and also this country, Laopedia, as well as Bangladesh. According to the statistics, the population we have is about 56 million as per the 2023. So we have like a climate like tropical, monsoon, cloudy, rainy, hot, humid, summer. So these are one of the good points for tourism. So, and actually in religious, Buddhism is our major religion, about 80% it has. We also have like own dialect, and also we have like more than 135 races in our country. So this is just, introduction about our country, Myanmar. And this is, I'd just like to introduce we have, the laws and regulations, as well as the what is our tourism policy in Myanmar for tourism. So I'm not sure, I think you can see clearly that we have Myanmar tourism law that was enacted on September 2018, that was about 5 years ago. And also we have like tourism rules and regulation, and we also added them on November 2020. So it means that we have like, a strong, laws and regulations to protect not only for the tourism businesses, but also for the tourism stakeholders, both locals and foreigners. When we talk about the tourism policy, it is very clear that we only have six tourism policy we focus to implement the tourism industry in Myanmar. So the first one is, we target tourism as, the most important contributor to the national economy. And the second one is we have, aware about how to preserve and conserve our tourism related, resources. So, and also we like to improve, the heritage and custom of the people in protection of their, ways of life and also culture and natural heritage of Myanmar. And the second one is through the implementing and promoting the tourism industry, we like to develop and improve our socio-economic of the people. And the fourth one is that according to the regional cooperation, through the like bilateral or regional agreement, we would like to implement that kind of contracts and MOU or agreements for the goods of the our national interests. So that's why we are here. And as part of the ASEAN Member State, we have like cooperate cooperation mechanisms with ASEAN, as well as GMS, CNMV, ACMAN, PINSET, something like that. These are one of our intention to get the strength of regional cooperation. And the last one is, not the last one, the most important one is, we would like to contribute our tourism industry in the peace building process. You know, currently happening in Myanmar is not really a good situation for tourism, but at the points of tourism view, yeah, we do think about the peaceful in country. So that is also one of our important tourism policy in Myanmar. And the last one is we wish to develop the sustainable and inclusive tourism throughout the country. So based on that laws, regulations, and policy, we are implementing a lot of activities and projects in order to meet these policy and regulations. So these are just, it will choosing the our laws, regulations, and policy. The next one I'd like to quickly go is about after the rules and regulation, we have policy, and then it's followed by strategies and vision. Since 2011, I hope everyone might aware that our country changed from military government to democratic nations in 2011. So since that time, the Ministry of Hotels and Tourism just developed the responsible tourism policy. That is the very basic principles and guidelines we enacted by the ministry. And secondly, we also noticed that if we want to develop the tourism, we cannot leave behind the participation of our local community. So the next step is we develop the community involvement in tourism. That is also basis principle for the involvement of local community for the development of tourism in Myanmar. And the third one is the most important one, which is a master plan. We have with the support of ADB and other development partners, we developed the Myanmar Tourism Master Plan 2013 to 2020. For 7-year master plan we have. And also we have like a project for about 38 projects. So in order to promote tourism as a destination among the region. And then we also have like ecotourism policy and management strategy. That kind of strategy is cooperated with the Ministry of Forestry, because ecotourism is not under the Ministry of Tourism. So we cooperated with the Ministry of Forestry, and we launched the ecotourism policy and strategy. And of course, we encounter the pandemic in 2020. So of course, one of the member countries of ASEAN, we also have our own, strategy for Myanmar to recover from the pandemic. So with that, I'd like to introduce the visions and mission statements. So according to what we develop, like responsible tourism policy, community involvement, then we have master plan, and we also have like a strategy for ecotourism. So thinking all into account, and we develop like the vision statement, missions and guiding principles, as well as we have like a strategy program, 6 strategy program incorporating like cross sector, such as environmental protection and gender equality, something like that. So together putting into one platform. So these are the visions and mission for tourism industry in Myanmar. And of course, according to the pandemic, we developed the Myanmar Tourism Strategic Recovery Roadmap 2021-2025. So we have a vision that tourism will be a significant contributor to the national economy, and will foster the stability and socioeconomic prosperity of our people. So that's why, Ministry of Hotels and Tourism encourage the protection of cultural heritage and improve the natural environment for future generation by promoting sustainable and responsible management of our natural resources. So based on that, post recovery vision, so we listed, we divided the priority actions of program, and a total of 93 specific actions we plan to undertake under the 18 strategy. So, and then we also, identify which are important to implement right now, which are important later on. So we categorize the 93 action like which are to implement immediately, which are for the medium term, and which are for the long term. So we have like, a specific vision and strategy for the post COVID-19 plan. So this is just, introducing the visions of the Myanmar Tourism Treasury Recovery Roadmap for the post COVID-19. After that, I'd like to move about the tourism statistics up to 2013. So maybe you can see on the slide that the blue graph show the arrival for international visitors. As you can see on the slide that we received actually 4.68 in 2014. So before the pandemic, we received actually 4.6 million tourists in 2014, and then the arrival go down, and we up again. But in 2019, so we received 4.36 million. That is, the second largest figure for Myanmar. But as due to the pandemic and challenges we are facing, the focus cut down, and last year in 2022, we only received 0.23 million. So that is really challenging for our tourism industry. But at the time, pandemic really highlighted as the importance of domestic visitors. So in that case, including Myanmar, every country, put our efforts to develop our domestic industry. So in this case, you might aware that starting from 2011, so visitor arrival for domestic tourism go up. So and last year in 2023, we received 9.71 million. So before the pandemic, so international visitor arrival is 4.3 something, and domestic is 5 something. So a total of more or less 11 million. But nowadays in 2013, so the figure changed reversely. Domestic tourism is improved until to 9.7, while international only 1.23. But at least we have, when we make a comparison to the numbers of the visitor, so it is equally, in 2019 and 2023 is equally, but different in international and domestic, but the numbers of visitors in the country is almost the same. So there is a kind of balancing between international and domestic visitor. So that's why we can say that the tourism industry in Myanmar, the tourism stakeholders of our country, like hotelier, travel agency, they can, revive their businesses relying not only on the international, but also for domestic arrival. And the next point is about, I like to share the top market. So when we are talking about the tourism, of course, every country has their own, top market. So this figure shows from 2017 to 2023. And also, you may notice that Thailand and China are our top market for Myanmar. So the green Chuck highlighted that Thailand took the first position, while the yellow one tell us that the arrivals is dominated by the China. And of course, very significantly, Japan, yes, one of the our top markets, stood at the top place in every year, starting from 2017 to 2023. So Japan remained the same at the top place, while you know China and Thailand, you know, took the position routinely first or second. So this is just I like to introduce the top market of our country in tourism. This is the slices I like to introduce about the reserve of the statistics, and also because last year in 2022, with the support of Mekong Lanchan Cooperation Fund, we have like a project focusing on strengthening the tourism statistics. Due to the project, we have a lot of you know statistics. And among others, yeah, I'd like to introduce you all the outcomes of some highlight points. The first one is, you know, transport mode. When we collect the survey, and the results show us that apart from the total visitor arrival, so when we categorize, you know, only 64-something was visited by air. Why? You know, 36 came from our border checkpoint, such as Thailand, India, and China. So, and also, when we then categorize again the types of visa, so basically the most significant type of visa is business and followed by the tourist visa. And also when we think about the check land border, most of the visitors came to Myanmar through the temporary border pass. It was about, you know, 80-something percent. And interestingly, when we narrowed down again the purpose of visits, of course, the first pie graph showed that, you know, business visa is, you know, dominated the about, you know, 50-something percentage. So when we categorize again the purpose of visits, most of the visitors were business and followed by tourism, such as for holiday, leisure, recreation, something like that. And also we have like MICE, VFR, what we call VFR, visiting friends and relatives, and also meditation, pilgrimage. And also, as I mentioned earlier, that when we look at the top 10 markets of our country, so China, Thailand, you know, still first and second. So you may also notice that the blue one highlighted the numbers of visitors from Thailand, while the orange indicate the numbers of visitors from China. So this is the transfer mode and also purpose of visits to our country. Of course, now we are doing, you know, we are also a member of ASEAN member states. So taking this opportunity, I'd like to share the arrivals of intra-ASEAN visitors. Of course, just I mentioned earlier that, you know, Thailand is one of the top market. So when we do the comparisons between the ASEAN member state, of course, Thailand, you know, stood the first place. But I'm sorry that, you know, for 2023, the data is say compiled, so I cannot get the updated data for the intra-ASEAN visitors. And next, I'd like to share the statistics, which is about the, you know, investment in the accommodation sector. So the graph show, of course, our country is, you know, you know, our countries have, you know, 14, seven regions, seven states, and one union territory. So a total of 15 regions we have in Myanmar. So when we, the broken down the accommodation infrastructure, a total we have like a total of 2,300 something numbers of hotel in Myanmar, and that the graph shows the accommodation of room number that the regions and state can provide. So when we check the graph, so Yangon, of course, the former our capital of Myanmar, you know, stood the first place with 25,000 hotel rooms, and followed by Mandalay, 21,000. So a total of 90,000 hotel rooms we have in Myanmar. So these are statistics about the hotel rooms and numbers of hotels and motels in Myanmar. And next, I'd like to share is about the travel agency. Of course, we are now operating the tourism businesses. This information is also, you know, very important. So as, I'm sorry again that I cannot provide the updated, figure for 2023. But in principle that, the number of travel agencies or tour guides is, improved. But comparing between the pandemic 2021 and post-pandemic 2022, we have the improvement is very positive, and still we have more than 800 something travel agency at the moment in our country. So when we're talking about the tour guide, a total of 4,500 tour guide, and also regional guide, we have 2,500 something, a total of. But of course, due to the lack of, job opportunities industry, in order to, fill up the gap happened by the pandemic. Okay, now I am at the media of my presentations. This is about the visitors and connectivity information I'd like to share. So, in total, so our country exempted the 23 countries for official visa. So including ASEAN member countries, Bangladesh, Brazil, Colombia, China, India, Japan. But among them, so we also exempt the visa realization for Russian visitors due to the close cooperation with Myanmar and Russia. So, and also for the purpose of tourism, so we also granted the visa on arrival for tourist visa, including China, Italy, Australia, Germany, India, Spain, Switzerland, Australia, Hungary, something like that. Actually, we can also conclude the information that these are also one of our targeted visitor for 2024 onward. When we talk about the connectivity, of course, as you can see on this slide, so maybe right-hand side, I just listed down the numbers of international airlines that operate currently operated in Myanmar. So a total of 15 international airlines, including our national airlines, operated the transportation and also facilitations of connectivity between Myanmar and other neighboring countries. And when if and also we have also direct flight between Myanmar and Russia, our national airline called Myanmar Airways International launched the direct flight between Myanmar and Russia Novosibirsk, started on last year September 2023. And hopefully that in the future, we wish to welcome more Russian visitors to our country. So for the domestic airlines, just five airlines only operated at the moment. And so this is also a good opportunity for investors who wish to invest in the transportation. So we have, a very huge potential for those who are interested to invest in Myanmar. And now I will move to the topic number six. This is about wine tourism in Myanmar. As I presented earlier, that you know, we have like you know, one of the biggest country in Southeast Asia. So in ASEAN, we are the second largest country after Indonesia. So we have, you know, actually a very huge resources for tourism. So as you can see on the screen, you know, we have, you know, very good natural resources, not only culture, but also heritage, natural. So we have, you know, a lot of wonderful destinations and attractions in Myanmar. So actually, at the moment, we have like only four key destinations. Maybe some of you might know that Yangon, Bagan, Inle, and Naypyidaw. But we also have good, you know, secondary destinations, but that yet under unexplored destinations. So, so we are also thinking about to, you know, to discover that kinds of hidden destinations in Myanmar. So this is just introducing for those cultures and religious traveler who wish to come and visit to Myanmar. We have a lot of you know, pagodas. That's why Thailand is the one of the our big you know, market, because you know, Thailand also most of the Thai visitors they prefer to visit the pagodas. So these are most popular cultural and religious destinations in Myanmar. But not only if you come to visit Myanmar, not only pagodas, you can also enjoy, you know, nature-based tourism, such as trekking or, you know, camping, and also, yeah, there are several activities you can enjoy in the nature in Myanmar. Of course, when we talk about the nature-based tourism, we also have, you know, a very good ecotourism. Previously, we have more than, around more or less 22 ecotourism sites in Myanmar. Some of them are, you know, Ramsar site, and some of them are, you know, ASEAN heritage sites. So we also have, you know, a very good ecotourism site. Yeah, I'm not sure exactly, but previously I noticed that we have, yeah, more or less 22 ecotourism sites. Of course, we have mostly we have pagodas, and then we have the nature, we have ecotourism, we have adventure. We have snow in the northern part of the country, and also we have beaches, and also we have like you know, trekking, and you know, so many adventure tourism you can also explore in Myanmar. And then when we implement the tourism, we should not forget about the community, because community is very important, you know, to promote the tourism in every country. Of course, we also have, you know, like a policy book for community involvement tourism. And also, we really implemented the policy. So before the COVID-19, we have more or less 46 community-based tourism sites in Myanmar. And also, these CBD sites really, really, you know, contributed to the development of socio-economic of our people and community. So, yeah, in the future, we will also keep continued to, you know, encourage the redevelopment of the community-based tourism, despite we have, you know, several challenges. And of course, we have, you know, we have more than, you know, 2,000 kilometer coastline we have in Myanmar. So we can offer, you know, a very good, you know, beach and spine. and but due to the lack of the infrastructure in connectivity, all the beaches enter the unspoiled, situation. Of course, you know, related with the beach tourism, we also have like marine tourism, and you know, we have like very good, you know, scuba diving and kayaking and, you know, snorkeling sites. And also, you can also explore for those who left the marine tourism. Yeah, so we would like to welcome to do the marine activities in Myanmar. Okay, I like to go. That is about just, I like to introduce, you know, we actually, Myanmar can provide, you know, investment opportunities for every investor. And also, not only for the hotel, but also in tour agency. As well as, you know, as I mentioned earlier, investors can also invest ecotourism and also community-based tourism. So this is, you know, the information I would like to share. And this is just, I like to share the investment, tourism investment in Myanmar. So the graph, the table show that up to now we have 74 hotel apartment project with the values of 4 billion something US dollar. But overall, we have like more than 9 billion investments for all sectors. But among them, tourism, you know, took the 4.5 something billion with 74 project. One more interesting thing when we talk about the investment, we have like a special land use right. That is for the investment, we provide 50 years and then 10 years plus 10 years, two times. So a total of 70 years investor can, you know, can get the land use rights. So this is the also good opportunities for the investor. For the tax exemption, you know, we allocated, we categorize the country, and also we identify zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. Zone 1 represents the light blue, while zone 2 orange, and also zone 3 blue color. So for the zone 1, the tax exemptions can get for about 7 years, while in zone 2 can get 5 years, and zone 3 like Mandalay, Yangon, so they can get 3 years. Okay, okay, this is my maybe less presentation, less slides about the key activities we undertaken in 2020. Actually, I already introduced at the beginning. So these are the key focus areas for tourism development in Myanmar. Actually, at the moment, the ministry prioritizes one important thing, which is to reduce the barriers of tourism operating in Myanmar. And also, we prioritize studies and research, institutional strengthening, and regional cooperation, like, you know, ASEAN, something like that. This is, you know, special business model. Currently, the ministry is implementing what we call public-private dialogue model. So, particularly, we focus only 5 areas. The first one is Asia capacity development. The second one is facilitation of digital entries and connectivity development. And the third one is ease of payment and tourism promotion fund, and also infrastructure development. And also the last one, but not the least, is for the product development and marketing. Taking this opportunity, I'd like to highlight some highlight that is about the regional cooperation. You know, last year, we signed the bilateral agreement with Russia and to foster the human resource development and also infrastructure and also, you know, sustainable practices. And also we participated, as you know, several international and regional meetings, forums, and also travel shows, including the travels. So these are some, you know, the highlights that I like to focus for the regional cooperation. And of course, you know, the countries now, you know, prioritize the market for Russia. So last year we organized the familiarization tour for the Russian market, and we sent them to the throughout the countries, showing that Myanmar is, you know, also safe for traveling, despite, you know, we are facing several challenges. As for, of course, you know, we contacted the country for the Thai market, because Thai also our, you know, top one or top two markets. So we are with the cooperation with TTAA, so the Myanmar Union of Myanmar Travel Associations organized the fund trip for the Thai market. And also we have one more events that will be took place in Myanmar. So maybe if you are interested, please save the day. And we will contact the Myanmar Tourism Mart 2024 in March 14 to 16, Yangon, Myanmar. So this is one of the activities of Myanmar Tourism Marketing. Okay, last but not least, this is, you know, some future outlooks that we will be undertaking for the development of regional and national tourism cooperation, as well as for the development of tourism in Myanmar. So firstly, we will organize the Chinese, you know, fun trip in upcoming February 2024. And of course, we are a member of ASEAN. And today, ASEAN is hosting 59 ASEAN and youth meetings. So Myanmar is the next host for the 60th ASEAN and youth meeting. So we were tentatively to be scheduled in Bakan in July. So, and also, we also will host the ASEAN committee meeting in October 2024. And, you know, in Thailand, with the developing of, you know, post 2025 strategy, now ASEAN is considering to, you know, to develop the post 2025 strategy plan, as well as GMS. So in line with that, we were also developing our national strategy plan post 2025 in the future. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, that you know, we believe that in order to upgrade the tourism in Myanmar, we need to narrow down the gap of the barriers of our tourism enterprise. So we will also set this kind of barrier through the public-private dialogue model. And of course, we need to also get the Asia capacity. So we were also focusing the opportunities to improve our Asia capacity by operationalizing the ASEAN MRTP. And last but not least, we will also strengthen our close cooperation with Myanmar Tourism Federation and brother associations. So actually, we plan to do the media briefing together with my colleague. Actually, he is vice chairman from Myanmar Tourism Federation, as well as chairman of Myanmar Tourism Marketing Association. Yeah, previously we plan to do the media briefing between by cooperation with private sector and the ministry, but only one place to do the presentation. So I'm just doing it alone. Okay. Sorry that. How can I? So this is the end of my presentation. Before I open. Okay. This is the end of my presentation. So yeah, this is the end of my presentation. And if you have a question, okay, please.
Hello, Luc Citrino for Travel Inside in Switzerland. I'm looking at your figures, and I see that last year, so you had 1.2 million, which is basically the level you had 11 years ago. So that means that in 11 years, all your tourism growth has been wiped out. Could you tell me when do you expect really a turnaround? What is your target? 2015 is the year you had the most tourists, 4.7 million. So when do you think that you might reach it again? And what would be the next step for the government to push back tourism? I mean, is it on the visa question? Is it about airlines? Because obviously you don't have so much flights anymore, despite the, what you showed. So just tell a bit about the future and what also for a budget do you have? Is the government really committed and pushing again the destination abroad?
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for your question. Yeah, the question is very good. Yeah, of course, you know, everyone of you know that we have, you know, several challenges. Yeah, at the moment we are facing. Yeah, that is true. But you know, for the Ministry of Hotels and Tourism, you know, we have to do something. Even we are, you know, encountering, you know, the challenges we cannot, you know, expect. You know, we cannot tell tomorrow what will happen, right? But that's why the ministry has, you know, a vision to, you know, to rebuild the tourism industry. But starting with realizations of the visa. But last year, yeah, I mentioned in my presentation that last year we received only 0.22 million. But actually, we just estimate to improve about 10% of last year. So it means that actually for this year, we just previously we expect 0.3 something. But at the end of this year, we received 1.24 something. So that is about 450% increase compared with last year. You know, we are located in the a very strategic place because we are situated between, you know, China and India. So we have, you know, a lot of opportunities. So in this regard, so we've, you know, granted the visa on arrival for Chinese and India starting from August 2023. So with that initiative, so this year we received 1.24 something million visitors. So, and also on the other hand, of course, we know that we need to collect all the strengths of private as well as public sector, because if we want to grant the visa, we cannot do alone. We have to get the support of immigration and also Ministry of Foreign Affairs, something like that. So that's why we established like PBD model. Yes, PBD model. This is the one that we intend to, you know, deeply implement starting from 2024 onward, and hope that we will do more activities together with private sector and also with our you know, related government centers. So yeah, as I mentioned already in my presentation that the PBD model only focuses 5 areas. So that is really cover for the sustainable tourism development for Myanmar starting from this year 2024 onward.